Hi students, have a nice day. Today we are going to learn about 10th science. The topic name is nuclear physics. In this lesson we will learn about discovery of radioactivity, natural radioactivity and artificial radioactivity, nuclear fission and fusion process. In 1896, French physicist Henri Becquerel finished his research for the week and stored a certain amount of uranium compound away in a drawer for the weekend. By chance, an unexposed photographic plate was also stored in the same drawer. After a week, he returned and noticed the film had been exposed to some radiation. He discovered that he could reproduce the effect whenever he placed uranium near a photographic film. Apparently, uranium radiation is something that could affect a photographic plate. This phenomenon was called as radioactivity. Uranium identified to be a radioactive element. 2 years later, the physicist Marie Curie and her husband Pierre Curie detected radioactivity in pitch blende, a tiny black substance. They were not surprised at the radioactivity of pitch blende, which is known as an ore of uranium. Later, they discovered that the radiation was more intense from pure uranium. Also, it was found that the pitch blende had less concentration of uranium. They concluded that some other substance was present in pitch blende. After separating this new substance, they discovered that it had unknown chemical properties and also emitted radiation spontaneously like uranium. They named this new substance as radium. The radioactive elements emit harmful radioactive radiations like alpha rays, beta rays and gamma rays. Next, we move to definition of radioactivity. The nucleus of some elements is unstable. Such nuclei undergo nuclear decay and get converted into more stable nuclei. During this nuclear reaction, these nuclei emit certain harmful radiations and elementary particles. These phenomenon of nuclear decay of certain elements with the emission of radiations like alpha, beta and gamma rays is called radioactivity, and the elements which undergo this phenomenon are called radioactive elements. Next, let's learn about natural radioactivity. The elements such as uranium and radium undergo radioactivity and emit the radiations on their own without any human intervention. This phenomenon of spontaneous emission of radiation from certain elements on their own is called natural radioactivity. The elements whose atomic number is more than 83 undergo spontaneous radioactivity. For example, uranium, radium, etc. There are only two elements which have been identified as radioactive substance with atomic number less than 83. They are technetium with atomic number 43 and promethium with atomic number 61. Next, we move to artificial radioactivity or induced radioactivity. The phenomenon by which even light elements are made radioactive by artificial or induced methods is called artificial radioactivity or man-made radioactivity. This kind of radioactivity was discovered by Irene Curie and Joliet in 1934. Artificial radioactivity is induced in certain lighter elements like boron, aluminium, etc. by bombarding them with radiation such as alpha particles emitted during the natural radioactivity of uranium. This also results in the emission of invisible radiation and elementary particles. During such a disintegration, the nucleus which undergoes disintegration is called parent nucleus, and that which is produced after the disintegration is called a daughter nucleus. The particle which is used to induce the artificial disintegration is termed as projectile, and the particle which is produced after the disintegration is termed as ejected particle. When the projectile hits the parent nucleus, it is converted into unstable nucleus, which in turn decays spontaneously, emitting the daughter nucleus along with an ejected particle. Next, we move to differentiate between natural radioactivity and artificial radioactivity. The emission of radiation due to self-disintegration of a nucleus is called natural radioactivity. The emission of radiation due to disintegration of a nucleus through induced process is called artificial radioactivity. Next one, alpha, beta and gamma radiations are emitted in natural radioactivity. Mostly elementary particles such as neutron, positron, etc. are emitted in artificial radioactivity. Natural radioactivity is a spontaneous process and artificial radioactivity is an induced process. It exhibited by elements with atomic number more than 83. It exhibited by elements with atomic number less than 83. And last one, the natural radioactivity cannot be controlled, but artificial radioactivity can be controlled. Next, we move to units of radioactivity. The first unit is curie. It is the traditional unit of radioactivity. It is defined as the quantity of radioactive substance which undergoes 3.7 into 10 power 10 disintegration in unit second. Therefore, 1 curie is equal to 3.7 into 10 power 10 disintegrations per second. The next unit is becquerel. It is the SI unit of radioactivity is becquerel. It is defined as the quantity of 1 disintegration per second. Next one, Rontgen. It is the radiation export of gamma and X-rays is measured by another unit called Rontgen. One Rontgen is defined as the quantity of radioactive substance which produces a charge of 2.58 in 10 power minus 4 coulomb in 1 kilogram of air under standard conditions of pressure, temperature and humidity. Next, let's learn about properties of alpha, beta and gamma rays. The first property is nature. The nature of alpha rays, that means helium nucleus, that symbol is He2O4, consisting of 2 protons and 2 neutrons. Next one, the nature of beta rays or electrons, that symbol is E-10, basic elementary particles in all atoms. Next one, the nature of gamma rays or electromagnetic waves, consisting of photons. Second property is charge. Alpha rays are positively charged particles and beta rays are negatively charged particles and gamma rays are neutral particles. Next, third one, ionizing power. Alpha rays are 100 times greater than beta rays and 10,000 times greater than gamma rays. Next one, beta rays are comparatively low and gamma rays are very less ionization power. And fourth one, penetrating power. Alpha rays have low penetrating power and beta rays are penetrating power is greater than that of alpha rays. They can penetrate through a thin metal foil, and gamma rays have a very high penetrating power greater than that of beta rays. Next one, effect of electric and magnetic field. Alpha rays are deflected by both the fields and beta rays are deflected by both the fields, but the direction of the deflection is opposite to that the alpha rays, and gamma rays are not deflected by the both fields. And last one, speed. Alpha rays speed ranges from 1 by 10 to 1 by 20 times the speed of light, and beta rays speed can go up to 9 by 10 times the speed of light, and gamma rays travel with the speed of light. Next, let's learn about radioactive displacement law. In 1913, Soddy and Fajans framed the displacement laws governing the daughter nucleus produced during an alpha and beta decay. They are: when a radioactive element emits an alpha particle, a daughter nucleus is formed whose mass number is less 4 units and atomic number is less by 2 units than the mass number and atomic number of the parent nucleus. And second one, when a radioactive element emits a beta particles, a daughter nucleus is formed whose mass number is the same and the atomic number is more by 1 unit than the atomic number of the parent nucleus. Next, we move to alpha decay. A nuclear reaction in which an unstable parent nucleus emits an alpha particles and forms a stable daughter nucleus is called alpha decay. For example, decay of plutonium to uranium with the emission of an alpha particle. Plutonium 240 and 94 to gives uranium 236 and 92 and alpha particles helium 2 and 4. In alpha decay, the parent nucleus emits an alpha particle and so it is clear that for the daughter nucleus. The mass number decreases by 4 and the atomic number decreases by 2. Next, let's learn about beta decay. A nuclear reaction in which an unstable parent nucleus emits a beta particle and forms a stable daughter nucleus is called beta decay. For example, beta decay of carbon. In beta decay, there is no change in the mass number of daughter nucleus, but the atomic number increases by 1. Next, let's learn about gamma decay. In a gamma decay, only the energy level of the nucleus changes. The atomic number and mass number of the radioactive elements remain the same. For the next video, we will learn about nuclear fission reaction. Thank you, students.